Ornatrix for Cinema 4D allows you to create hairs and edit them by directly drawing them on top of your character. Let's quickly see how this is done. So I have a base surface here, which is my character's mesh, and it doesn't have any separated scalp or anything. This is just a body mesh, and I'm going to use this to create hairs for my character. So I'm just gonna set up my operator stack by creating a default quick group, and I'm gonna adjust it by setting the guide count to 0. When I do that, all of the hairs and guides disappear. I'm also going to add a mesh from strands operator at the end, just so that we visualize the hairs a little bit better, including their thickness. And I'm going to change my width to a smaller value. And in hair from guides, I'm going to increase my viewport percentage fraction to 30%. So on to the important part of this video. We go to edit guides, and in edit guides, if you scroll down, you have this draw strands tool option here, which you can click to activate inside the viewport. All of the parameters above it control how the strands are drawn. So right off the bat, if I just click and drag on my mesh, I can create a guide by drawing it. If I create one more guide, then we start getting some hairs that are kind of interpolated between those two guides. If we draw a third guide, we get another guide that now generates the hairs that are interpolated between those three guides. As I keep drawing and adding more guides, I can refine the shape of my hair and make sure that it fits the exact criteria that I need, with very fine control over the drawing process. I can go and change the thickness of my guide width just a little bit so that they're more visible inside the viewport. And now we can explore some of the options that are available here. Just to see the guides better, I'm going to turn off hair from guides from now, so we see our guides. So the first option, or the first two options, are create new strands and edit existing strands. Once I have drawn a guide, I can always draw on top of it to modify its shape relative to the current viewport. I can also start drawing on top of a guide and finish drawing on top of the same guide to modify its shape in the middle between the starting and drawing points. This way I can create some minor refinements. If I have the edit existing strands option off, this will not allow me to do that. Instead, the only thing I will be able to do is to click on the surface to create new guides. This may be useful to turn this option off when you don't want to get existing guides in the way and you just want to create new guides all the time. On the other hand, you can edit the existing guides without creating new guides. If I turn off the create new strands option, then I can no longer click on the surface of my mesh, but I can still modify the guides by clicking and dragging on top of them. The third option specifies the number of points that are created for the new guide. I can increase this value to create some really, really smooth guides. Of course, I need to check the create new strands option on. So once I do this, you can see that the guides have very many divisions and they are a lot smoother. Whereas if this value is very small, then creating large guides will result in fewer segments being created. So the created curve will always get reinterpolated using the number of points that you have specified using this point count parameter. The next option is the draw along surface option. When this option is off, if I start drawing my guide on top of a surface and I continue drawing it, it's going to be created in the viewing plane of the current viewport. Even if I start drawing on top of my mesh and I continue and drawing on top of the same mesh, the guide is going to be flat and it's not going to follow the mesh surface. But if I have this option on and I draw along my mesh surface, then the guide will follow the contour of the character's mesh. This is very useful when you're drawing something like fur, or even if you're drawing hair that you want to follow the character's surface. The next option controls the distance from the surface for this draw along surface option. Right now it is 1. And you can see that as the guide goes along its length, the distance from the surface slightly increases. So it's going to be increased until this value that we specify. So if I set this to a higher value, maybe like 10, just for demonstration purposes, and I draw on top of my surface, then you see that the guide starts really close to the surface, and along its length, it keeps moving away from the surface. And the point at which it will stop is this distance from surface. So it's good to keep this at a smaller value if you want the guide to closely follow the surface. Apply smoothing parameter additionally does some smoothing to the guides. If you have this off and you draw some squiggly lines, it's going to kind of just follow the lines that you draw naively and create this squiggly shape. However, if you apply smoothing and you set the smoothing parameter to a higher option, if you have squiggly lines, it's going to try to smooth them out to create a smoother curve for you. So this is good to have by default. The select edited strands will select the strands that you have created, and the maximum length option allows you to control the length of the guides that you have created. So if I set this to a smaller value and I keep drawing the guide, it will only draw the guide up to the length that I specify. Again, if you're drawing something like fur and you want it to remain relatively short, then this is very useful to maintain the length of the fur without having to worry about stopping at a specific point. So this tool can be used to create hairstyles very quickly, and in conjunction with the other editing tools in Ornatrix, you can create base grooms or even final grooms in just a few clicks.